Thank you. Monica, all yours.
Thank you so much, Steph. And I have two short notes for you. I'm aware of the time. And our colleagues will come here because we'll show you a video, a short video today of the PGA volunteering with the entire team in a Queens Park in New York, New York City Parks. And I understood for the first time that film, Home Alone, because I was in the office alone today. So this is also my cue to apologize to you who have been writing to me in regard with the speakers list. So I send it to you a short while before coming here. But so I may start?
2 minutes.
Yeah, I will show the video afterwards. Is that okay? Because then we can gain time. So this morning, Mr. Shahid and his team volunteered at Cunningham Park in Queens planting trees to celebrate United Nations Day. Mr. Abdulla Shahid said that as a Maldivian, he knows very well the concept of community and of depending on your neighbors. The PGA explained that this volunteering work before his high-level meeting on delivering climate action on October 26 here in New York and before COP26 in Glasgow shows that everyone can play a role in climate action. New York City Parks informed that the PGA, that this was the very first official tree planting of the autumn season, and there were about 350 trees planted by the PGA and the team today. I heard from a colleague that they were quicker than what they thought they would be. Of course, everybody was well equipped to do the job. Today. Mr. Shahid said also that volunteering work at Cunningham Park is about recognizing the principles of the UN and what drives us to do the work: equality, sustainability, peace and prosperity, giving back to our community, working across regional and cultural divides towards a common goal. And here at the headquarters this evening at the J Hall, President Abdulla Shahid will take part in the UN Day concert under the theme, you know already, Building Back Together for Peace and Prosperity, which is being organized by the Department of Global Communications and with the support of the Permanent Mission of the Republic of Korea. Mr. Abdulla Shahid released a letter to member states yesterday announcing the names of the 11 members of his advisory group on gender equality as well as two observers. The PGA is grateful for the participation of Her Excellency Ms. Alia Ahmed Saif Al Thani, Permanent Representative of Qatar, Her Excellency Valentin Rwagbiza, the Ambassador of Rwanda, who also chairs the Group of Friends on Gender Parity, His Excellency Mr. Jukka Salovaara, Permanent Representative of Finland, and also Ms. Tilmiza Hussein, Ambassador of the Maldives. I think now, if you have your mic open, if you could just, yes, close it down. That's a little bit. Yeah, thank you so much. I will continue. And then also, Her Excellency, Ms. Griselda Araceli Gonzalez Lopez, Permanent Representative of El Salvador, Ms. Sima Sami Bahuz, Executive Director of UN Women, Ms. Ilse Brandt-Skerris, Assistant Secretary General for Human Rights and Head of the Office of the UN High Commissioner for Human Rights, Ms. Reem Al-Salem, UN Special Rapporteur on Violence Against Women, Ms. Sanda Ojiambo, CEO and Executive Director of UN Global Compact, the Honorable Patricia Torsney, Permanent Observer of the Inter-Parliamentary Union, and Dr. Sum Young Yum, UN Representative of the International Alliance of Women and Chair of the Board. And there are two observers, Ms. Catherine Pollard, USG for Management, Strategy, Policy, and Compliance, and Ms. Jayatama Rikmanayake, the SG's Envoy on Youth. And the board will serve as an informal mechanism to facilitate critical thought and advice on gender issues. Okay, on the PGA's agenda, finally, before we show our video, Mr. Shahid started the day, as you know already, volunteering at Cunningham Park in Queens, where he and the team planted 350 trees. This afternoon, he will meet His Excellency, Mr. Dritan Abizovic. He is the Deputy Prime Minister of Montenegro. The PGA will receive at his office Lord Armand of Wimbledon, who is the Minister of State for South Asia, UN, and the Commonwealth. This evening, Mr. Shahid will speak at the UN Day concert, and later he will attend a dinner hosted by the representative of Italy to the United Nations. So we'll go to the video, and then afterwards I have a colleague in the back. Thank you, Philip. Can we have the sound as well? Or? And it's about a minute video. I think that's it. I have a call, but I am in the... Yes, it's basically it, right? So that was the start. And then, of course, another video was sent to us towards the end. But, of course, we had to work our way to show it to you. So I think you have to tell me where we have it at the end. Yeah, unfortunately, we don't have the sound, but that's okay. So we can, yeah, thank you. That's very kind. Thank you so much. So this is Mr. Abdulla Shahid and the team. Yeah, go ahead. How are you today?
Good. Thank you, Monica.
Philip.
The list you sent. Yes. Yesterday you said it was it would be an hybrid debate. So this list, all these people are coming to UN?
Or no, it's a hybrid. You are absolutely
so
right.
So can you tell us which of these people are going to come?
Yes, it's a hybrid event. We will receive videos, and we will receive, of course, some of them will be here. So we are working to make it clear on the list. You are absolutely right. The list indicates the heads of state and government, the ministerial level, but not who is on the video and who is not. So I'm trying to get that with the team when they come back from the park and they give it to you, because I know it's important. Yes, and then what I always have to say, Philip, is that we received word that there might be a few changes to the list in regard with adding more speakers, and of course, as soon as I receive it, I'll send it to you. Anyone else? On the screen, I can't see anyone, so anyone speaking up. In this case, I would say thank you so much. I will see you tomorrow, okay, for our last day in this week. See you tomorrow. Thanks.